Right now in WDSU First Warning Weather, we have got a lot to talk about. I want to start off with WDSU First Warning Weather Doppler radar quick, but right after this, we are going to see exactly what's coming our way and the potential for the tropics. The tropics will be on our minds all week long as the system Potential Tropical Cyclone 6 has already formed in the southwestern Gulf of Mexico. It's going to get its act together over the next day and the next 24 hours. And then beyond then, it's going to be tracking our way. Already start to see after comfy air is dropped in place, there's a little return of some humidity. Lower Plaquemines, mouth in the Mississippi, has already found a few showers making the way back. You can see in the Gulf, we still have some shower activity. That's the direction there as well. This isn't any rain. This is just a little bit more, some more humidity trying to move in, but there's a good look at the picture of what we've got in the way of those systems coming in. So let's cut right to the chase, which is the most immediate concern. Potential Tropical Cyclone 6. What does that really mean? Well, we know this is going to be a storm that will form, becoming tropical. It will impact land. That's why the National Hurricane Center wants to give the best outlooks and issue what it's got at this point. By Wednesday afternoon, this thing could be a Category 1 hurricane. This is most likely to be named Francine. If something forms before then it's Gordon. But either which way, Category 1 with wind 75 miles per hour. You can see this is going to be west of us right now. Continues to make its way on shore, and then it's a tropical depression from there. So what does it stand right now? Why is it not even deemed a tropical depression at this time? There just isn't much organization that's here. You can see the estimated area of low pressure really with storms that are west of it here, but you can also find an area of storm activity that's going farther north. Water temperatures, no problem here, well into the upper 80s. A lot of atmospheric humidity, so it's going to be moist and unstable with that heat of the ocean. The only thing that'll be battling here is wind shear. So these are stronger winds in the subtropical jet stream that I've looked at that could have an interaction to keep the storm from maybe becoming the worst it could be. So there is one determining factor there that might hold things down. Storm tracks from the National Hurricane Center shown here. More storm tracks from the National Hurricane Center from a forecast that we do here in the United States called the Global Forecast System. When you put all of these tracks together, I've kind of drawn on a medium track here for you where I believe that to be. And still it sets up just west of New Orleans, unfortunately might be taking it right through the town of Cameron. We all know too well what's happened with Cameron before. Here's our forecast again, the GFS. Shows by Tuesday, this is most likely to be a named storm. There's the landfall potential forecast coming into Wednesday. Another forecast out of Europe. These are very similar to each other. Tuesday, we've got formation into our next named storm. Then by Wednesday, making its way on shore, and we're not done with it until we get more into Friday. We're looking at a lot of rain with this, folks, here first. This is first up, our rain threat. Rain threat from there, it's going to be also some gusty winds on the east side of it, but storm surge with wind, water being pushed on shore. Here's just a look at that forecast. I want to show the winds in relation to us, where it's set to be exactly in the high-res forecast. You can see that one headed west. Here are the wind gusts forecast for us, and look at this one. The winds could really pick up, gusting to 30, possibly over 50 miles per hour. But then finally, and I know there's some breaks in the data, it's going to be the wave heights here. Some significant storm surge could be coming our way. So the all takeaway here is the east side of the storm will be on. Significant coastal storm surge and heavy rain. But unfortunately, being on the east side of the storm, we have a tornado threat with this too. So we are going to have to upgrade to a WDSU First Warning Weather Alert Day all ready for Wednesday, knowing the storm will be in the vicinity right on our doorstep. We will continue to monitor and track the exact track it will take, but regardless of where it goes, we will still have all the impacts and more I just discussed right there, Elizabeth.